前橋と申します。カーディフ大学で翻訳と通訳の勉強をしています。主に日本語と英語、あと英語から日本語 の実践での翻訳のトレーニングを受けています。そう、寄せ書き日の丸は第二次世界大戦中に、あと日本語では太平洋戦争中に出征する兵士の周りの人々、家族や親戚、あと村の人や町の人が一人一人直筆で名前やメッセージ、それぞれ、それから印象もしましたね、捺印したり、それぞれのメッセージを託した日本の旗です。それから日本の国旗は日の丸と呼ばれています。白地に赤い太陽の丸があるんですけど、その周りに兵士の名前、武運長久などの題が書かれて、その周りに人々の名前が奉仕状に書かれていたり、あと熟語、漢字の熟語が書かれたりするんですけれど、日本語では寄せ書き日の丸と呼ばれます。英語では Good Luck Flag と呼ばれます。今でも日本では寄せ書きの慣習は残っています。
I'm Rachel Adams. I'm the Museum Curator of the Fire and Ice Museum of the Queen's Dragoon Guards and the Royal Welsh. And we're a regimental museum that represents over 300 years of history relating to the Welsh cavalry and the Welsh infantry. The biggest inspiration for this project was the fact that we had such little information about the artifact. So all we know about it is that the Japanese flag was captured at the end of the Second World War by soldiers of the Welsh Regiment in Burma, and we have no further information. An artifact like this tends to fall into regimental collections, and regimental museums are very specific in their remit. We're here to tell the stories and history of our regiment, and so we always tend to focus on the regimental perspective rather than the other narrative, and I think that's why historically for so long we actually haven't thought about doing translation work. Something that we've been working on historically is getting language students from the university in to do translation of the museum displays, but when Tameo approached us about wanting to volunteer, because she's Japanese, it just seemed too good an opportunity, and I felt that rather than do something mundane about translating museum displays, I'd like to take this artifact and do something quite specialised with her work placement project. It's been a great process for us to work with Cardiff University in a different capacity, because normally we get archaeologists or historians coming for work placement. There's also this now whole new relationship between us as an organisation and Tameo with the work that she does. And I think for us to get somebody in from a different context, a different department, and to actually bring a fresh perspective to what we do here, I think that's been a really great process to go through. And it's all those what might seem like tiny interactions between one person and another person, but the impact of that tiny interaction is actually quite massive in terms of what we can then achieve and the stories that we can tell with a single artifact.
I'm the deputy curator here at the Royal Welsh Museum in Brecon. I've been here for about 7 months, so I'm still fairly new. To prepare the flags for translation, we had to remove them off of our display cabinet in the museum. So we had to do that before we opened. Myself and my colleague Richard, we took them off carefully off the displays, and we actually found we had an extra one that we didn't realize was in the cabinet because it was folded and kind of behind another item. So that was a fun surprise. And then I brought them up into this room and placed them on acid-free tissue paper. We knew very little about the flags other than a description that this was a Japanese flag with some characters on it from X date, so pretty much the 1940s. But apart from that, there's no other information in our database of what they are, really. I think with the new wave of curators coming into post, that they're wanting to shed light on what's already in the collection and try and research more into objects that we already have and on things that were unknown before. And now with the internet and resources that we have today, that we didn't have, say, 20, 30 years ago. We can go into a lot more detail and try and unveil what's actually in someone's collection.
The ear, 1940s. They're all 1940s. Mm.
翻訳は直訳から始まったんです。それ、直訳をした後に日本の歴史やあと現代の事情を調べながら訳していきました。言語学や翻訳学から見ると、その時代を象徴する文字や漢字、あと社会、それからその兵士のコミュニティ、あとその当時の人々の思いや人々が考えていることを表現されているので研究の対象になります。誰に送られたかっていうのは旗を見てすぐ分かったんですけれど、日の丸の周りにそれぞれ筆を取って書かれていったんだと思います。人々の名前や四字熟語があったり、あと印象がおら押されたりしていたんですけれど、ただところ場所によっては布が破れていたり、それで読めない字もあったので、その場合は日本語で書かれた一人一人の名前、あと君が言うと、あと四字熟語、あと印象、それぞれ英語に訳していきましたが、でも実際に旗に書かれていない背景にあるその時代の事情やあと漢字の意味を伝える作業、面白かったんですけど大変でした。翻訳や通訳は皆さん簡単にできるだろうと思ってるんですけれど、実は簡単ではないんです。でもその簡単ではないということを説明するのも簡単ではないんですけれど。
I really do think that people relate to people. And I think that when visitors come to a museum, it's not the object in its own right that interests them. It's the same thing with medals. It's not the medal itself that is significant. It's the person who was awarded the medal and it's what they did and how that relates to the artifact.I think this project is the first pilot for us in moving in a different direction into the future for how we look at the collections that we have. As we develop partnerships and relationships with different communities and different people, they're going to have a greater expectation of what we can offer them. And I think there's, as we get past the point of there's not many Second World War veterans surviving anymore, it's really important with this object because soon we won't have anybody who has a direct memory to the Second World War. So it's really essential that we start to kind of use our collections more effectively and in a more clever and smart way. We want our objects to almost resound in telling their own stories rather than us having to kind of give a very generic interpretation of what they are.
The thing with working with military things is that there's a lot of pride behind some of the objects that we find. And you can clearly see it here by a whole community coming together, villagers' names and seals from shrines, and almost like a token that they can carry their community with them. And I find that in our culture, we don't really do that on a mass scale of that. We kind of do things when they finish or when they die. Because I know in the States, when a soldier passes away, they have the American flag draped over their coffin, and then that's folded up in a very specific way, and that's presented to the family. And a lot of them put it in a shadow box. So I have one in our house when my grandfather passed away. Not in battle afterwards, but they still get remembered with total respect like that. And I think in the United Kingdom, I know in World War I, soldiers, when they came back alive, communities would pitch in together and buy them a pocket watch and engrave into. We've got a few of those in the collection. So it's not a huge thing, I don't find, that our cultures do. So it's a nice way to show the differences between our culture and their culture and the different ways it all comes together and tells a bigger story.
そうですね。個人的にはこの翻訳を通して多くのことを学びました。というのは、私が日本で学んだ、勉強した歴史というのはわずかなものでした。それからウェールズで日本語から英語へ翻訳するという経験も貴重でした。日本語から英語に訳すこと、また英語から日本語に訳すこと、英語とは日本語とはその時代に生きていた言葉、また今は死んでしまって誰も使えような言葉、そういう言葉をよく知りました。
It's a huge benefit to the museum because before we can't read it. None of us here can read Japanese, so it was a piece of text that no one knew. They can only guess at what it was, and I think some people's ideas were that it was like little good luck omens and stuff of that nature, but not actually what the information is, which was a huge thing to find out. Because now we can understand what one, what the flags are, and two, better inform our collection, so everyone can know more about it. We can tell the public when seeing the flag, no, that's not just a flag with writing on it. It had so much more meaning to it.
I think it's really important to understand fully what artifacts represent and symbolize. We can't get away from regimental museums being textbooks on walls unless we fully understand the human nature of artifacts. The fact that we now know what all the signatures on this flag mean and they've been fully translated by Tomeo means that we can get an understanding of the person who owned the artifact and the context in which he lived and the community in which he lived. And I think it's really important if we are going to tell the story of an object, we need to understand it in complete form. And we didn't do that before.
From a museum's perspective, we try to show both sides of a story and not be totally one-sided. So by having this information that we didn't have before is extremely amazing and hugely beneficial to the museum and our understanding. So objects that were once silent can now speak for themselves.